Tonight, the Daytime Emmys celebrates all of you, the members of our community, in front of and behind the camera, creating the magic that is daytime television.
So many incredible moments this year, and what do all these moments have in common?
Love.
Five minutes. 525,000 moments so dear. 525,600 minutes. How do you measure a year? In daytime, in sunsets, in midnights, in cups of coffee, in inches, in miles, in laughter, in strife. 525,600 minutes. How do you measure a year in daytime? How about love?
Minutes.
525,000 journeys to belay.
525,600 minutes.
How do you measure the life of a woman or a man?
In truth that she learned, or the tears that she cried,
bridges he burned, or the way that she died.
The 44th Annual Daytime Emmy Awards.
Award for Supporting Actor in a Drama Series. Please welcome Adrian, Lonnie, Jeannie, and Tamara, my good girlfriends from The Rio!
Gory is one of the most competitive with the largest number of entries.
So, of course, it's true. Through a tribute to five fine actors who became tonight's nominees.
Mm-hmm.
They play a family patriarch, good guys, bad guys, and one of them plays both a good guy and a bad guy. So
here are the fabulous nominees for Outstanding Supporting Actor.
As Dylan McAvoy, The Young and the Restless.
See that guy? He's gonna be your dad and I'm gonna be your fun uncle.
He's gonna love and protect you as much as I have.
Because I love you more than anything.
Chad Duell as Michael Corinthos, General Hospital.
He was desperate, he was scared, and he needed you, but you couldn't be bothered because you were too busy screwing Dylan. You're the one who put Morgan in that car, Kiki. You're the one who killed him. Okay.
Jeffrey Vincent Paris as Carlos Rivera and Dr. Joe Rivera, General Hospital.
The world is my oyster. Fate brought me to this church. Now fate has brought you right to me.
Who is going to be the winner? I can't wait.
I'm excited.
And the Emmy goes to Steve Burton as Dylan McAvoy, The Young and the Restless, CBS.
Thank you. I'm gonna try to stay on time. First, I'd like to thank the good Lord for his love, grace, and mercy, because I feel I wouldn't be here without him. My wife, thank you, honey, for all you do for me and the kids. Oh, McKenna, Jack, Brooklyn, I love you guys so much. Mom, Jill, thank you. Maurice Bernard, thank you. Doug Davidson, thank you. CBS, Sony, The Bells, thank you. It was an honor to be a part of your show. I love you guys. Writers, directors, producers, the cast, you guys are amazing for just letting me become your family. I thank you guys for that so much. Oh, gosh. Everybody that I worked with just to get this award, I thank you, and the crew. I love you guys so much. You guys pour your hearts every day for us, and I'm utterly so thank you for that. Thank you, guys. I love you.
Our next two presenters are from General Hospital, and I love that show. from the Chalcedonians to the Corinthians. And in my mind, I believe me and Epiphany are sisters. Please welcome a guy that always needs to keep his shirt off, Curtis Ashford. And Sam McCall, AKA Kelly Monaco, and Donnell Turner.
Oh, yeah. Okay, so we are presenting the award for Outstanding Younger Actress in a drama series, which means they're all under the age of 26. Now, I don't know what you were doing at 26, but I wasn't nominated for no awards.
I don't think I can talk about that. Being young in daytime drama doesn't, however, mean being inexperienced. Between them, the five nominees tonight have logged over 1,000 episodes and 22 seasons on their shows.
Now, here are those young but experienced nominees.
Outstanding Younger Actress in a Drama Series. Lexi Ainsworth as Christina Corinthos Davis, General Hospital.
I wasn't sure that you'd still want me around.
I would never give up on you.
Could you accept a gay daughter?
No question.
Veneer as Nell Hayes, General Hospital.
Please, you cannot tell Carly about any of this. I don't want her to look at me differently. Please, I am begging you, you cannot tell her.
Okay, here it is. The Emmy goes to Christina Corinthos.
G-H.
General Hospital, Lexi Ainsworth. Yeah, baby.
Congratulations. I'm holding on these. Wow. Okay, I want to thank my parents for sacrificing everything for me to be here today. I want to thank Ingrid. I want to thank my manager, Jesse. I want to thank my agent, Tyler, for having faith in me. I want to thank Frank and the writers for trusting me with this storyline and for letting me be a voice for the LGBTQIA community. And life is not black and white. There's a lot of gray in the world, and we don't have to understand it, but we must show compassion to every person out there because we don't know what they're going through and we don't know what their story is. Everyone is fighting a battle, and don't give up the fight.
And the goal we're presenting is for Outstanding Drama Series
Indeed.
Directing Team.
These four directing teams are the hardest working in the business, so let's take a look at the nominees.
Outstanding Drama Series Directing Team, The Bold and the Beautiful. Days of Our Lives.
Freeze! Drop your weapons.
General Hospital. The Young and the Restless.
The screw up who slept with my wife.
All right. And the Emmy goes to General Hospital.
All right. Wow, okay, wow. My colleagues and I would really like to thank you for this honor. We thanks to ABC, Vicki Dummer, and Rebecca Campbell. Thanks to our extraordinary EP, Frank Valentini. And thank you to the entire creative, smart, funny, slightly nutty General Hospital family. You make our work really easy, and it's a joy to work with you, and we are nothing without you. Thanks so much.
An actual daytime legend. a woman who has played one of the most popular characters in daytime ever. I'm talking about a scheming vixen, a lady who's kidnapped people, stabbed people, shot people, went to jail, and stared down a bear. Went through 10 marriages, 6 of them were legal. Now y'all better act like you know and get up on your feet for a true queen of daytime, Erica Kane herself, Emmy winner, Susan Lucci.
Oh my goodness. My goodness. Thank you so much. I'm so happy to be here tonight, and so happy and proud to be here to pay tribute to the great Agnes Nixon. Agnes Nixon was a visionary. She was a fearless and triumphant storyteller. She was not content only to imagine and create characters and stories. She had the courage and determination to get them onto network television. Agnes Nixon was a pioneer. It's safe to say that she has touched the lives of millions and millions of viewers, but she has also touched the lives of so many of us who are here tonight in the theater. In November of 1969, I was auditioning for the role of Erica Kane on a brand new show. Okay. On a brand new show called All My Children, which was set to premiere in January of 1970. It was my 5th callback when I caught sight of this petite, very pretty blonde woman in a cocoa brown Yves Saint Laurent pantsuit, zooming into a control room in the ABC studio. It was the first time I had ever seen a professional woman in action, and it was the first time I had ever seen such a designer outfit in person. I recognized it from fashion magazines that I had read in college, and I had just recently graduated. But I didn't know that the woman in a hurry was Agnes Nixon, who created the show. And not only that, she of course had written the scene that I was just about to audition with. A knockdown, drag-out fight between a 15-year-old, fabulously flawed Erica Kane and her much more sensible mother, Mona, played by the wonderful Fra Heflin. The mother-daughter stories that I had grown up seeing were always so reverential, like greeting cards, but this one was realistic. This one was in its way revolutionary, like so much else that Agnes introduced to television. She always said that her first responsibility was to entertain, but her second was to inform. And Agnes used her many successful shows to start conversations about drugs, transgender issues, homosexuality, the Vietnam War, and interracial relationships. And she always did it with humanity and with every character's point of view portrayed. And Agnes did this at a time when none of these issues were being portrayed on television, day or night. Agnes wrote stories long before they appeared in the headlines or primetime. In fact, it was the character of Erica Kane who had the first legal abortion on TV, not Maude. Let's just say that Agnes Nixon had a double whammy of storytelling DNA. Her Irish ancestors, whom she spoke of with such affection and gratitude for their inspiration, plus she grew up in the South, surrounded by its tradition of storytelling. And yet, no matter how successful Agnes was in her writing career, Agnes never, ever lost sight of her focus, which was her family. Toward the end of her life, Agnes became a little fragile physically, having battled Parkinson's disease and then a stroke. But she still remained the youngest mind in the room. We would go out to dinner. She'd be wearing one of her Pucci dresses. She'd be looking fabulous. She had a little trouble walking, but she did walk. She had a little trouble speaking, but she kept on telling stories and even jokes. The spunk, the spirit she had throughout her life and career never left her. She had just finished her memoir, My Life to Live. And the night before she died, she asked her son, Bob, to read and reread the book jacket to her so she could sign off on it. And she did. Some of Agnes's family is here with us tonight. And I know that they know how much Agnes was loved. You just had to love this warm and brilliant, gracious and inclusive woman. I am so proud to say that Agnes Nixon was my friend, my mentor in every way. She was someone I looked up to and someone I treasured. I love you, Agnes.
You are all my children.
Bucky Dog, I have the privilege of saving dogs from shelters and having them find the perfect home. When they asked me to present tonight, I know I feel the same way. When they asked me to present tonight, they told me I would have a co-presenter. What they didn't tell me is that I would have 50 of them. From the Daphneland Basset Rescue Organization, I give you the March of the Basset Hounds. Is this not the most adorable thing you've ever seen? They'll get up here eventually. We have one last one. Don't worry, he's old. Come on. Each and every one of these wonderful dogs is looking for a permanent home. If you'd like to apply to adopt one or more of them, here's how you do it. Simply go online to daphneland.com for more information. The Daphneland Bassets and I are presenting the award for Outstanding Younger Actor in a Drama Series. Let's take a look at the nominees.
Outstanding Younger Actor in a Drama Series. Brian Craig as Morgan Corinthos, General Hospital.
You didn't go to a hospital!
You have got to stop it, Morgan!
No, you wouldn't just put Dad in a hospital! Why me? What have I done that's worse than Dad?
As TJ Ashford, General Hospital.
Even if you did have your reasons when I was a kid, I'm a grown-ass man now. And you still lie to me. Why?
And the Emmy goes to Brian Craig as Morgan Corinthos, General Hospital, ABC.
Wow.
this is one for the books, huh? Let me just start off by thanking everyone that made the decision to give me this character. Frank Valentini, Mark Teschner, chime in. ABC, Laura Wright, everyone that had a hand in giving me this character, thank you so much. I wouldn't be here without you. I want to thank my mom, my dad, my awesome little brother. My best friend Aaron came here with me tonight, so thank you for doing that, buddy. You know, I couldn't ask for better representation. Richie Konigsberg, two of my agents, Steve LaManna and Robert Haas are here. Thank you guys for just directing me in the right path. Thank you for my group of actors. I could not have pulled this storyline off without you. My family, Laura Wright, Chad Duhl, Maura West, Dom, Maurice Bernard, thank you for giving me so much of your time, dude. Like, this was your baby and we made it come to life, and I'm so proud of it. Thank you. Again, I share this with anybody who suffers from mental illness. This is more than just a storyline for me. We brought awareness to this. The biggest reward was having people come up and saying that we helped them get help. I mean, that was amazing. So we hear you. Thank you so much for this.
Still to come, Harry Connick Jr., TV game show icon Savannah White and Alex Trebek, and Tim Allen presents the Lifetime Achievement Award to Mary Hart when the 40...
So, Mario, are you a fan of General Hospital?
Yeah, you know what I am, and as a matter of fact, I just hosted the Nurses Ball this last week.
Wow.
And they had my family on, everybody was so nice and very cool and everything. Anyone a fan here at General Hospital?
Yeah! I'm talking about a real fan of General Hospital. Okay, because we have one of the stars of General Hospital presenting a little later on the show, and we're going to let one of you super fans of General Hospital present an award with him.
So who's it gonna be? Who's it gonna be?
I think right here, this lovely lady.
I saw this hand go up first.
Yay.
Yay.
Thank
you. Yay. You're welcome. What's your name, dear?
Stephanie.
Stephanie, where are you from?
Originally from Jersey.
All right. You're a big fan, you said?
Yes, I am.
I wonder.
All right, well, listen. Stephanie, Cheryl and I are going to take Stephanie backstage to get ready. But first, we have to introduce the next presenter. He is a star.
Who watch us every day. We really, really appreciate it. 20 years ago tonight, ABC aired Ellen's Coming Out episode. 20 years ago, it was a really big deal to say you were gay on television. Ellen did not come out publicly for the ratings, for fame, for fortune. She did it because it was the right thing to do, and the time was right. That episode of television was really about the best thing television can do. It brought people together. It was historic. It was funny. It started important conversations. It changed people's minds, and it saved lives. Ellen, you inspired us then, and you inspire us now. To Peter Roth, Mike Darnell, Donna Redier-Linsk, and our good friend Dave McGuire, thank you so much. To our families and friends, we love you.
General Hospital and a nominee tonight, Jeffrey Vincent Paris, and General Hospital superfan from the balcony, Stephanie Reichardt.
As a General Hospital fan, I just have to say, this guy was robbed.
Oh!
Kidding, I'm kidding, Steve, you're great.
First of all, I would like to say, on behalf of General Hospital, and in fact, on behalf of all the daytime dramas, we're lucky to have great fans like you.
Thank you.
We appreciate your love and your loyalty.
Max Eric is a singer and actor. Many of you will know from The Young and the Restless, Under the Dome, and many other shows. He joins me on stage tonight to help pay tribute to those people in the daytime industry that we lost this past year. people in front of the camera, behind the camera also. Many of them personal friends. We mourn their loss, but because their work endures, they will be remembered for a very long time.
David played and it pleased the Lord, but you don't really care for music, do you? Well, it goes like this, the fourth, the fifth, the minor fall, the major lift, the baffled king composing, hallelujah. Maybe I've been here before. I've seen this room and I've walked this floor. I used to live alone before I knew you. And I've seen your flag on the marble arch. And love is not a victory march. It's a cold and it's a broken hallelujah. All I've ever learned from love is joy and pain will both flood right through you. And it's not a cry that you hear at night. It's not somebody who's seen the light. It's a cold and it's a broken hallelujah. Hallelujah.
Welcome the Chairman of the Board of Trustees of the National Academy of Television Arts and Sciences, Chuck Dages.
As Chairman of the National Academy of Television Arts and Sciences, it is my pleasure to welcome you to the 44th Annual Daytime Emmy Awards. The Daytime Emmys began as an awards program in 1974 at a skating rink in New York City's Rockefeller Center. And here we are this evening at one of California, Southern California's most magnificent landmarks, the Pasadena Civic Center. It was on this very stage that Michael Jackson introduced the world to his moonwalk in 1983. And it was home for the primetime Emmys for years. Quite a journey for daytime. Daytime television is alive and well, and we are here tonight in honor of all of you who raise the level of excellence each and every day of the year. It is with this in mind that we celebrate these esteemed nominees, honor their many accomplishments this evening, and on behalf of our Board of Trustees, our Executive Committee, our staff at the National Office, and the many television professionals who are making tonight's presentation possible, we thank you.
can't get it.
The Talk.
That we even stood a chance, I swear to you. And all the time I'm going, because I honestly do, I love the view, and I'm going, the girls from the view have got it in the bag. And I'm like in shock. Yeah. There are so many people, oh my Lord. Angelica, I love you, Angelica, for believing in us and pushing us. And John Redman, we love you. Naughty John Redman, we love you. And Kristen and
yes,
Heather.
Yes, Kristen Matthews, yes. And Heather and Angelica.
And Les.
Les, Glenn Geller.
And
we got to give it up. We're bringing it home, Julie.
And Lori Seidman.
Yes.
Oh, my Lord.
We didn't write a speech. That's why we don't know what we're doing up here. We didn't expect to win.
Oh, my God. I'm glad my wig didn't
Julie Chen, we love you. Julie couldn't be here. We're not wrapping it up. Julie couldn't be here tonight, but we couldn't do it without her at the helm with her careful and very sure hand. Look, guys, we love each other, and we love what we do. And we're so lucky to be up here and sharing this day with you. Thank you, everybody who comes and visit us. Please come and see us at the Talk. We're so grateful. Thank you. We are presenting the award for lead actress in a drama series, and the nominees are all wonderful and talented actresses, Blair.
Oh, yeah, and they are no strangers to these awards. Between the five of them, they have 36 Daytime Emmy Award nominations and 12 wins.
Wow. All right. Well, Blair, let's see him in action.
All right.
Outstanding lead actress in a drama series, Laura Wright as Carly Corinthos, General Hospital.
Our boy is dead. Our beautiful little boy is dead. And you killed him!
Tony Oni as Phyllis Summers, the young and the restless.
I had rage and I had anger, and I could not find my way out of that. And you didn't want to see it. I thought if I could be vindicated, I'd find my way back to some sanity, to being me and to being whole. I just felt empty. And I want to be whole again.
Nancy Lee Grant as Alexis Davis, General Hospital.
Go look at that knife because it's clean, Alexis.
You cleaned it! You cleaned it! I'm looking for proof for what you said! What you said! Stop it!
Wow. Oh, my God. Blair, I wish I could have done that to my two ex-husbands, throwing a knife like that. Oh, my gosh. And the Emmy goes to... Oh, my goodness.
Gina
Tognoni! I have to thank God. I have to thank you, fans. Thank you. I have to thank God for this gift. To be nominated with the women this year, they are so intelligent and so strong. What an honor. You are all magnificent. Magnificent.
I especially share this award with my beautiful, beautiful husband, Joseph. Wave, honey. You see, I couldn't do this without you. I wouldn't want to do this without you. I love you. You are my gravity. And I share this with you. I also want to say hello and thank you to my family back east in New Jersey. Oh, my friends and my family, my Hoboken crew who is here.
Lifted as Liam Spencer, the bold and the beautiful.
It doesn't really matter if I love her because she's not coming back to me. It doesn't matter. After all, look, this is what she did to show her commitment is perfect.
Who? Scott Clifton as Liam Spencer, the bold and the beautiful. The first male actor to win Younger, Supporting, and now Lead Actor.
Oh my God. Oh my God. I really didn't think that would happen. I was getting really comfortable in that seat. Wow, I'm going blank right now. Thank you so much.
Please welcome the Empress of Soul, Miss Gladys Knight.
Thank you. I'm so honored to be here to present this final award tonight for Outstanding Drama Series. Let's not keep the fans waiting. You know, the show is in suspense. I love you too. I'm sorry about that. I heard it. Yes, I did. My husband and I were saying, isn't it ironic? A night presenting at the Daytime Emmys, that is really something crazy. So here are your nominees.
Outstanding Drama Series, Days of Our Lives.
Tell me that you don't love me.
I'm not sure I ever did.
The Bold and the Beautiful.
You had this secret ears all these years.
You don't know how hard I tried.
The Young and the Restless.
I hate you for what you did to me.
General Hospital.
The cops show up here.
Oh my goodness. And the Emmy goes to General Hospital ABC.
On behalf of the entire cast and crew of General Hospital, we'd like to thank everyone at ABC, Vicki Dummer, Nathan Varney, Rebecca Campbell, Dom Nuzzi, Heidi LaBelle, anyone who I forgot. I promised I would do better this year. I'm sorry, I'm very nervous. We would not be standing here without the incredible writing skills and talents of Gene Passanante and Shelley Altman and our entire team, Chris Van Etten, Dan O'Connor, Chris Weitzel. They're all so incredibly smart and fun and keep us challenged every single day. The cast is brilliant, we love them, and we wouldn't be here without the talent and the guidance of Maurice Bernard, who sadly is not with us tonight. But we love you, Mo, and we're thinking about you. I've got 1 second. Oh, I'd like to personally take a moment to just thank my family on the East Coast, who I miss every day, but this family here keeps me warm and happy. I love you all so much, thank you.
Daytime Emmys, we just want to thank everyone watching on Facebook and Twitter. Remember, it's better in daytime.